Today's dramatic Supreme Court showdown lasting more than 8 hours, if you were counting, the hearing playing out to many audiences and one in particular, the president, watching on Air Force One on his way back from New York to Washington and then watching it right over at the White House. John Carl with what the president is thinking about his nominee tonight.
Like the rest of the country, the White House was riveted by today's hearing. The word from those close to the president, he heard from Kavanaugh exactly what he wanted to hear. A passionate defense that hit back at Democrats.
My family's been destroyed by this, Senator. Destroyed.
And when Lindsey Graham lashed out at his Democratic counterparts.
This is not a job interview.
Yeah.
This is hell.
Sarah Sanders tweeted, Lindsey Graham has more decency and courage than every Democrat member of the committee combined. God bless him. This morning, all eyes were on Christine Blasey Ford. Capitol Hill glued to her emotional and raw testimony, even Republicans calling her credible. The president watched as he flew back from New York aboard Air Force One, and he was asked about it when he returned to the White House.
Are you considering a new nominee? Do you believe her?
Inside the West Wing, aides worried it wasn't looking good for Kavanaugh, an assessment shared by commentators on the president's favorite news channel.
In the middle of the afternoon, it's a disaster for the White House.
During a break in the hearing, Democrats stepped up their demands for an FBI investigation.
The FBI must investigate, and the refusal to do so is tantamount to a cover-up.
And while Republicans worried about Ford's testimony, Senator Lindsey Graham said he remained unconvinced.
A nice lady who has come forward to tell a hard story that's uncorroborated, and this is enough. God help anybody else that gets nominated. Based on what I heard today, you could not get a search warrant or an arrest warrant because you don't know the location, you don't know the time, and you don't have any corroboration.
And when a defiant Brett Kavanaugh came to tell his story, a dramatic mood change for Republicans.
Politically, if Republicans were gloomy 2 hours ago, I don't think they are now.
And sources close to the president say he is prepared to fight to get his nominee confirmed.
And John, this mood shift you speak of was swift this afternoon, and tonight we're hearing directly from a very confident president on this.
If the president had any doubts about the strength of his nominee, those doubts are gone. You mentioned the tweet that happened just as we came on the air. He said that Kavanaugh showed America exactly why I nominated him. He called it powerful, honest, and riveting. And David, he is saying that the Senate needs to vote and vote on this now.
All right, John Carl with us live tonight. John, thanks.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.